Good afternoon, students. Now we will discuss about AC bridges. These AC bridges are used to measure unknown value of resistance, inductance, capacitance. Okay, now we will discuss about measurement of self inductance. The self inductance of the coil can be measured by following bridge circuits. First one is Maxwell's inductance bridge. Second one is Maxwell's inductance capacitance bridge. Third one is Hayes bridge. Fourth one is Anderson's bridge. Fifth one is Owens bridge. Later we will discuss each and every thing. Now we will discuss about Maxwell's inductance bridge. In Maxwell's inductance bridge, we have to calculate the unknown value of the inductance in terms of known value of inductance. Okay, that's why we called as Maxwell's inductance bridge. This is the circuit diagram for the Maxwell's inductance bridge. In AC bridges, we have to replace D-arsenic galvanometer in place of vibrational galvanometer, or vibrational galvanometer, or we have to take headphones in place of vibrational galvanometer. In AC bridges, inductances are added to resistances, inductance and capacitances. Here we have to measure the values of inductance. That's why inductance values are added to the resistance values. We have to observe this diagram. Here this is the arm 1, this is the arm 3, this is the arm 4, this is the R4. Here we have to apply AC voltage to the circuit. Okay, the voltage across the first branch is E1 and voltage across the second branch is E2, voltage across the third branch is E3, and voltage across the fourth branch is E4. Now we have to balance the circuit. Already we know about what is the balancing condition of bridge circuit. If current through vibrational galvanometer is equal to 0, then the bridge will be balanced. That means E1 is equal to E2 or E3 is equal to E4. Already we know about Wheatstone bridge and balancing conditions. In Wheatstone bridge, we get balancing condition P by Q is equal to R by S. We have to cross multiply P, S and Q, R. From this condition, now we have to write the balancing condition for the Maxwell inductance bridge. Here P and S are represents opposite impedances. In Wheatstone bridge, this arm can be called as P, this can be represented as Q, this can be represented as R, this can be represented as S. By utilizing these values, we have to write the balancing equation. In place of P, we have to write Z1. In place of S, we have to write Z4 equal to. In place of Q, we have to write Z3, and in place of R, we have to write Z2. This is the balancing condition for the Maxwell's inductance bridge. Now this can be considered as equation number 1. Now we have to find out the values of Z1, Z4, Z3, Z2, and we have to submit that values into this equation. Here Z1 is equal to impedance of the arm 1. This is the arm 1. In arm 1 we have resistance and inductance values. By using this arm, I am writing impedance equation Rx plus j omega Lx. Okay, now Z2 is equal to this is the arm 2. From this arm we have to write the impedance equation for Z2. Z2 is equal to R2 plus j omega L2. Okay, Z3 is equal to, in arm 3 there is no presence of inductance here, so simply Z3 is equal to R3. Z4 is equal to R4. This can be considered as equation number 2. Now we have to submit this equation into equation number 1. Substitute equation number 2 in equation number 1. Z1 equal to Rx plus j omega Lx. And Z4 is equal to R4. Okay, Z3 is equal to R3 into Z2. R2 plus j omega L2. Now you can multiply all the equations. Rx plus R4 plus j omega Lx into R4 equal to R3 into R2 plus j omega L2. From this equation we have to separate the imaginary and real parts. Separate and equating the real and imaginary parts. Here this is the real part and this is the real part, and this is the imaginary part, this is the imaginary part.
Go.
By equating the real parts, we have Rx R4 is equal to R2 plus R2. Here R2 represents the internal resistance of the coil. Okay, that's why I'm adding here R2. Okay, from this equation we have to find out Rx value. Rx is equal to R2 plus R2 into R3 by R4. This is the unknown value of the resistance in AC circuit. AC circuit. Now equating the imaginary parts of the equation, j omega Lx R4 is equal to j omega L2 R3. Now j omega get cancelled to each other and get Lx is equal to L2 into R3 by R4. This is the unknown value of the inductance. This is the unknown value of the inductance in terms of known value of the inductance L2. Now we will see the phasor diagrams for the Maxwell's inductance bridge. Here we have to take I1 as a reference. I1 as a reference. And I1 is equal to I3 because bridge balancing, in bridge balancing conditions, current through the galvanometer is equal to 0. Then current flows through this branch is equal to current flows through this branch. Okay. Next, here in branch 1, inductance and resistance are there. From that E1 is equal to I1 into R1 plus j omega Lx. This is the equation, voltage equation for the R1. Now we have to draw the vector for the I1 into R1. This is the reference vector I1, and I1 R1 drop in phase with I1. I1 R1 drop in phase with I1. Now we have to add the inductance drop to E1. Okay, inductance drop I1 omega Lx. This is the resistance drop and this is the inductance drop. Now total voltage drop is equal to E1. Total voltage drop E is equal to E1. Already we know E1 is equal to E2 in the balancing conditions. Okay, and E is equal to E1 plus E2 or E3. E1 plus E3 is equal to E3. E is equal to E1 plus E3 equal to E2 plus E4. Okay, already we know the vector E1. Now we have to draw the vector for E3. Okay, here I4. Okay, voltage across E3 is equal to E4. Already we know in balancing condition of the bridge. Okay, from in arm 4, E4 is equal to in arm 4, we have only resistance. That's why I'm writing R4 into I4. This is the I4 into R4. Already we know E4 is equal to E3. So it is equal to E3 is equal to E4. Now what do you want? E1 plus E3. Already we know the vector E1 and this is the vector E3. By adding those two vectors, we get total voltage E. We have to draw the line parallel to this vector and this can be parallel to this vector. Finally, we got the equation E1 is equal to E1 plus E3 or E2 plus E4. This is the vector diagram for the Maxwell's inductance bridge. Thank you.